Hey guys, it's Drew Brashler. I am here today at Music Studios in LA with the Behringer X32, and I want to show you guys how to customize your board. And that's with the Assign section. Now, this is a user-definable section that gives you 8 buttons and 4 rotary knobs that you can control and program to anything on the board. Now, let's jump in to see how I would actually do this. Now, in churches, we typically will have all of our instruments, and then on some other layer, we'll have the pastor, and then on some other layer, we'll have the PC and music, and especially the video feed. Now, all of those things we have to be able to get to right away. And so one of my favorite things to do is on the last layer of the Assign section, actually program the pastor and the video feeds to be on this for me to be able to turn up and down my pastor, mute him, and even select his channel. So today I'm going to show you actually how to do that on the board. So the first thing that we want to do is we want to hit view on the Assign section. And we can see we have a home, set A, set B, and set C. So there's actually 3 different layers of your Assign section that you can program yourself. Now we're gonna go over to set C. So we're just gonna use our page select and go over to set C. Now we have our 4 encoder knobs and our buttons here, and they're each numbered individually. So first thing I'm gonna do is put my pastor on encoder 1. So to do that, we take our target type and put that to fader, and we assign. And then we have my pastor is on channel 32. So we're gonna take this and rotate this until we get to 32. So now we can see over on the Assign section that we have all of our LEDs here. And if I go back and pull up channel 32, if I turn this down and up, we'll see the fader moving up and down. So we'll put that back to 0. Now I also wanna be able to mute and unmute my pastor too from this screen. So let's go ahead and program button 5. So we're still here in the set, and we're gonna go scroll down to button 5. Once we're here, we're gonna go ahead and hit mutes, and then channel 32, assign. And then the last thing I wanna do is my bottom button here, which is number 9, I wanna be able to press that and go to the home page of my pastor's channel, which will also automatically select that channel. So we're gonna go to button 9, and we're going to jump to page, and channel, home of 32, assign. So now, if I go and hit my button 9 here, it's going to not only select my pastor channel, but it's also gonna pull it up on the home screen here. And my button 5 here will mute and unmute my pastor as well. Now lastly, I wanna program my audio from my PC and my video feeds as well into this. So let's go ahead and program those. So my PC is gonna be on encoder 3, so let's go ahead and hit view again, and we're gonna go up to encoder 3, and we are going to fader, and this is going to be on my aux 1 and 2. So because those two are linked, I'm just gonna program this to aux 1, and then I'm also gonna record my 4 here. So encoder number 4 is going to be my video left and video right. And since those are linked, I'm just gonna pull up video left, which is aux number 3. So we have encoder 4, and we're gonna go to fader, and aux 3, and assign. And then we wanna do the mute buttons. So 7 is going to be my PC. Which is aux 1, and then button number 8 is going to be the mute for aux 3, so let's go down to button 8, and mute, and aux 3. So now I have my mutes, so we can see that when I press these mutes, it also mutes the other side here. And also when I pull this, it will turn up and down those. Now lastly, I just want to program my 11 and 12 to be able to jump to those pages so I can automatically select those from this screen. So button 11 is going to be a jump to page channel of aux 1. And button 12 is going to be the jump to page of aux 3. So now when I am mixing my main layer, I automatically have a spot where I can go in and unmute the pastor just like that. Thank you so much for watching this video. I am Drew Brashler here at Music Studios in LA, and that is how I customize my X32 to what I want to have in this section. Thanks so much for watching.